हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 12, सब्जेक्ट बिजनेस स्टडीज, चैप्टर नंबर 1, इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. ओके, अर्लियर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द टर्म मैनेजमेंट, दैट व्हाट इज मैनेजमेंट. ओके, नाउ वी विल स्टडी व्हाट इज द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. फर्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंस इज अचीविंग ग्रुप गोल्स. मैनेजमेंट क्रिएट्स टीम वर्क and coordination in the group. Managers give common direction to the individual efforts in achieving the overall goals. Okay, what management does for achieving the goal of an organization, it creates the team of an employees or team of an individuals and coordinate them, all their efforts, and give them the common directions to achieve the overall objective of an organization. Okay, second type of the importance is it increases the efficiency. Efficiency, how it increases efficiency? It provides better resources, best possible resources with the very minimum cost, and also helps in increasing the productivity. Management increases efficiency by using resources in the best possible manner to reduce cost and increase productivity. Okay, third type of the importance is of management is creates dynamic organization. As earlier also we learned about this term dynamic, it means flexible. Okay, management helps the employees overcome their existence to change and adapt as per the changing situation to ensure its survival and growth. Okay, as earlier in the dynamic process, I've given you the example of the McDonald's firm. Okay, how it changes its menu because of the changes in the environment. So the same way the management should be such that it should change according to the environment or according to the situation. Okay, dynamic organization should be there in every firm. Then the next importance of management is achieving the personal objectives. Okay, what is the personal objective? That means fulfilling and satisfying the needs of an employees, that is personal objectives. Management helps the individual achieve their personal goals while working towards organizational objectives. Okay, for working towards the organizational objective, to achieve the organizational objective, personal goal has to be achieved first. Okay, personal objective, individual needs and wants should be satisfied first. Okay, this is the importance of management. Next, last point is development of society. Management also helps in developing the society. How? By fulfilling the social responsibility. Okay, management helps in the development of society by producing the good quality products, creating employment opportunities, and adopting the new technologies. Okay, so management also helps in providing the good quality product at the reasonable prices. Okay, providing the employment opportunities to all the employment opportunities to the number of individuals, and also protecting the environment, and also providing the new technologies, adopting all the new technologies and avoiding all the unfair trade practices. This helps in the development of the society. Okay. Now let us come to the second type of the nature of management, which is management as a science. Why management is considered to be as a science? What do you mean by science? Science, it is a systematized body of knowledge that is based on the general truths which can be tested anywhere and anytime. Okay, anywhere it can be tested, and it is based on the general truth. Okay, universally accepted it is. Science is that systematized body of knowledge. Okay, what is the features of science? Features are systematized body of knowledge it is. Second, science is based on the principles of experiments and observations. Okay, first of all, experiments are done and several observations are done. After then only, based on these principles only, the guidelines are applied. Okay, and the third is universal validity. Science is universally accepted. Okay, so as similar to science, the management also work like management has a systematic body of knowledge and its principles are developed over a period of time based on the repeated experiments and observations which are universally applicable. Okay, all the principles, like principles in the further chapters, we will study about the principles of management, which is the scientific management principles also, and all the traditional modern management principles also, which is of Henry Fayol principles. Okay, of the Taylor, all the principles we will study in the earlier chapter, in the coming chapters we will study. Okay. So, according to, based on that principles, the management has to work on the experiments and on the observations done by the thinkers. Okay. So, but all its principles are universally accepted, but they have to be modified according to the given situations. Okay. All these principles, they have to be modified. Means some changes the managers can do as per the given situation. Okay. That is why management is called as a science, because it consists of all the features of the science.